Action.
Welcome back to the Cider Barn Kitchen for another cooking adventure with Farm Camp Cooking at Home. So today we are going to make our own pizza, and it's going to be a veggie pizza. We got lots of yummy veggies for our pizza today, and I hope you do too. So I washed my hands, and I hope that you have too. And if you haven't, go ahead and take care of that, and then back here. So, the first thing we want to make sure is that we really have everything on our table ready to go. So, you want to make sure that you have your yeast packet and some sugar. You want to make sure that you have flour and olive oil. You want to make sure you have 3/4 of a cup of lukewarm water and some salt. So, and then of course we're going to need some measuring cups, measuring spoons, and whisk is nice. So the first step in our process, if you have everything ready, otherwise pause and come back when you are ready, is to get our yeast activated. So baker's yeast is a single-celled organism. When you look at it, it's simply going to look like a little powder. And to get the packet open, I actually used scissors to open it. It was a little hard to rip it. So I'm just going to put the yeast and the 3/4 cup of water. And how do you know it's lukewarm water? Is that you have your hand under the tap and it's not too hot to touch, but it's warm. That's kind of how you know it's lukewarm. So we're going to need to add sugar, and it's just a little bit. It's 1/4 teaspoon, 1/4 TSP, okay? So I have a lot of sugar here. It takes me a long time to go through my sugar. And, you know, we just always like to scoop and level. Scoop and level. And look at that. It's really not that much. I'm going to put it in. And the reason that we are adding the sugar is because this little one-cell organism, this little critter here, comes alive with the warm water and eats the sugar. That's actually its food. And then it makes bubbles, and that is what's going to help our pizza dough to rise. So we are just going to get that whisked, make sure it's all dissolved. And then we're going to set it aside for a few minutes, let it do its thing. And we can go ahead and get started. With getting our vegetables ready. So what I like to do with leafy things is to put them in a basin or to fill a sink with water. And just grab a little towel. So what I have here is spinach. Spinach is one of my favorite things. And dark leafy vegetables are just really superfoods. You can do a million things with something like spinach. And so I dunked it in my water. I shook it a little bit. And I'm just going to kind of just pat it dry a little. We'll let it sort of drain and dry for just a minute while we do the other veggies. So, you know what? I'm going to use a little bit of this water to be able to give a few other things a rinse. So I brought some mushrooms today. Mushrooms are one of my favorite things. Just doing a quick little rinse of our mushrooms. Okay. So, we are going to do a little bit of chopping. And I'm going to use, creatively, my pizza tray, my pizza pan. Anything really can be a cutting board. So for the spinach, I mean, honestly, if this was a salad, I would absolutely include the stems. And maybe